Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to perform the second experiment on attenuation. So we all are aware about the equation of our output power under attenuation, that is PO is equivalent to input power into 10 to power of minus alpha L by 10. Okay, so it's minus alpha L by 10 means alpha is your attenuation parameter, L is the length of the fiber, and PI is the input power. Now, if we simply try to plot this, the kind of output we will be getting is a constant curve corresponding to a constant input value of PI. But we all know that an optical pulse is a Gaussian pulse. So this input as well as the output is to be multiplied by this Gaussian parameter, which is e to power of minus x square by 2 pi sigma square, where x is the counter, that is the variable which is varying with the time, and sigma is the line width. So that will decide the width of a pulse and will help us to define the shape of our Gaussian pulse. Now for setting this counter x, we need to have a structure that will vary this x from say particular value to the second other value. Normally, if I set a counter at 100, the values will vary from 10 to 100, but we want a pulse to be centered at 0. Then we need to actually replace this x. We need to replace this x by x minus whatever the counter that we set divided by 2. So if I set a counter at say 100, then it becomes n by n minus 50. Okay. So now we are ready with what expression we want to implement using a lab view. So I'll in the front panel, first I'll select the inputs, that is my input power, the attenuation parameter, the length, and the sigma, that is the line width. That can be done by simply selecting the horizontal sliders for it. So for first slider is for my input power in milliwatt. The second slider I'll be using for selecting the attenuation in dB per kilometer. The third is the length in kilometer. And finally, one more that I need is a spectral width. For that, we'll go to the graph and select extended XY graph. The difference between XY graph and the waveform chart is that we are able to basically set this and fix this time axis. Similarly, for the output, again, we will select this. Now all our input and output terminals are set. We will go to the block diagram window and try to make our block diagram. Now first we will make a waveform for an input pulse. For that we will be first implementing this parameter and multiplying with the input power to get an input Gaussian pulse. Now in this, I need an X. As I said, we need to set a counter. For that, we'll be using our for loop, the structure. Go to the structure, select for loop. Now you have a counter. I can select this counter as 100. And then I can make this. Just for the convenience of the design, I have kept this counter above. So I need X minus 50. For that, I'll select numeric, subtract, and then I'll just select minus 50. For that, I'll create a constant. Now after x minus 50, I have to square it. So again, I'll select a numeric, square it. And now we have to negate it. Again, I'll select a mathematics. Either you can go to the mathematics and numeric and select negate, or from the numeric also. So I have negated. So I've created minus x square. Now what else I need is 2 pi sigma square. So I first need to square this spectral. Right? Squaring, then multiplying it with 2 pi. And the other is 2 pi. So create a constant. Either I can write the value, or I can, what I can do is I can select from the mathematical constants 2 pi and use it. So my term 2 pi sigma square of the denominator is ready. Now I'll take again a divide. Okay, so now I have created the term minus x square by 2 pi sigma square. What I have to do it is e to power of. So for that, I need an exponential. For that, we will go to mathematics, elementary, in exponential, and then select exp. So this, when I select, it will create the term e to power of minus x square by 2 pi sigma square. Now what I have to do is I have to multiply with the input power to get my input pulse. So what I'll simply do is I'll just take a multiplier. I can put it here and just multiply with the input. So this is my output. Now what is my x input? X input is this counter, x minus 50. So now in this extended xy square, there is a reset button which continuously resets device. So we need to make it, stop it from continuously resetting it. For that, we will be using a create a constant. So it's true, just click on it, it will become false. So it will stop continuous resetting the device and help us see the output. Now we have actually done half of our experiment by generating the input Gaussian pulse. We'll just run it and see whether it is working fine or not. So I'll just control E and I will increase my input power, attenuation, the length, and the spectral width. So as I increase the spectral width, you can see the shape. We can further do the beautification by adding the pattern, how we want it to look like, and we can add a color. So we can just see, we vary it. It actually has impact of only PI and PO, and you can clearly see it's varying from minus 60 to plus 60 because we have set a scale from minus 50 to plus 50. So that's how we are able to fix it. Had we taken a waveform chart, this would have been a continuously varying variable. Now what we have to do is, we already have our input power in. Now we have to do is calculate this output. For that, we need to calculate 10 to power of minus alpha L by 10. So what I'll do is, I need minus alpha L by 10 first. So first I'll make this product. Right click, numeric, multiply. Alpha L is there, we will now select, negate. We will select, negate. So I have now alpha L, I need to divide by minus alpha L, I need to divide it by 10. So what I do is again select from the numeric, divide. So Okay, so this is to be divided by 10. So right click, create a constant 10. Now what we can do is just connect it to the next output. Now what we can do is we need to multiply it output. This parameter is to be created. So we have now created minus alpha l by 10. Now we need to make it 10 to power of. For that again we will go to this mathematics, elementary, exponential. In this you can see 10 to power of. So I'll just take this. So this, now I have the term 10 to power of minus alpha l by 10. I need to multiply with pi, but here the pi what is expected is the Gaussian pulse. So what is this? Is our Gaussian pulse. So we'll multiply this with the Gaussian pulse to get our output pulse in. So again I'll use a multiply. So now we have created pi 10 to power of minus alpha l by 10. Now what I'll do is I'll simply take it and put it on the y terminal of our second device. X will be the same. Okay. And again we need to perform the same of resetting the, stopping the resetting by creating a constant and false. So this has actually, we have set our whole setup, but still it is showing some connections are incomplete. So we need to check. So this X, again, I'll make the connection. So now we can clearly see if the connections are complete. Now there is no break in the arrow. We will continuously just run it and see whether we are getting the output or not. We can clearly see corresponding to an output of say 4.2, what we are getting is 1.3 volts, millivolts of the output. Now I can again make the similar changes in the output plot in the size and the color. So this is my input and the output curve. Now we can clearly see as the input is varying, the output is varying. As attenuation is increasing, there's no change in the input power, but you can see the output is reducing. Now as I increase the length, you can clearly see the attenuation is increasing, the output power is reducing. As I increase, vary the spectral width of the input and the output power, and corresponding to the input, the output also changes by the similar. So in this, you could clearly identify what are the variations. You could clearly identify the variations in the output with the change in the length, attenuation parameter, and the change in the input power. Thank you.